Accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior today.
Whatever time frame you'll be listening to this video, of course, this is your brother in Christ. The reason of me coming on here today is I want to introduce you to a man named Jesus Christ, a man that loves you no matter what your background is, who you are, what lifestyle you're in, what race or nationality that you identify as. God himself sent his son, his forgotten son, Jesus Christ, into the world, not to condemn the world, but to save the world. And he loves you today. And he wants you to accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. So today, if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, but you want to get to know him, right now, not tomorrow, not next week, but right now, you can accept him. He is opening his arms, ready to receive you as his lost sheep. Because he loves you so much. And he's waiting on you. One day, the Lord Jesus is going to crack the sky open and he's going to come back for his fruit, for his people. And that's called the rapture. And my question to you today is, are you going to be caught up when the Lord Jesus returns back for his chosen people? I want to be caught up so I can reign with him forever. Do you want to be caught up so you can reign with him forever? God's wish is for none of us to perish, but to live everlasting with him. Hell was never meant for us. It was only meant for the devil and his demons. And daily, people are dying. Daily, people are dying because of decisions that they may make or just by the hands of someone else. And my question to you today is, if you were to die today or tomorrow, or if Jesus Christ was to make this your final day, do you think you'll wake up in heaven? Or do you wake up in hell? So please, I encourage you today, my brothers and sisters, to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior today. He loves you. He will always love you. And his love is everlasting. One thing I can say about Jesus' love is not only is it everlasting, but he's a loyal, he's a respectable God. He won't cheat on you. He won't leave you, nor will he forsake you. Even the word says that he won't do these things. So accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. Stop looking for validation from people that say that they love you and care about you, but they really don't. Because the God I serve, and the God that my brothers and sisters serve, can testify and say that he will never leave you nor forsake you. He will not cheat on you. He loves you. And his love, you will never find any love like this. His love is the epitome of agape love. He will never leave you alone. Even when you mess up, he's still going to be there to pick you up when others condemn you. So accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He wants you to reign with him forever. Amen. Never feel condemned. Never feel like you are an abomination. You are not an abomination. I even made a TikTok video last year encouraging the body, and even those that are in the world, that you are not an abomination, that the sin that you carry and live with and wear and have made your lifestyle is an abomination, but you are not an abomination. God hates the sin. He doesn't hate you. So to every person that is practicing lesbianism, homosexuality, fornication, adultery, he doesn't hate you. He never did. He hates the sin. that you're participating in. That's what he hates. Our God hates sin, but he loves you because he created you in his image and his likeness. And when he created you, it was good. So make this choice today and accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior so you can get the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And once you get that, the Word of God says, and it is written, that you are a new creation, that the old is gone forever. And keep it that way. And it's in Jesus' name. Amen. And if you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, he has forgiven you your sins. And the great part is, the Bible tells us that even after one soul has been saved, the angels in heaven are rejoicing. So welcome to the family of Jesus Christ. But like I said in the recent video, your walk, your assignments, your relationship with God don't just end here. There's more to it. So God bless you all. You guys be blessed. And if you can, share this video with someone else. God loves you. And I love you. And welcome to the family. God bless you all.